on fire. That's
perfect. Oh my god, I love it.
That feels good though, huh?
Yeah.
Oh.
God, no.
Yes.
Just arrived on the day before Shemanigans 2022-23 event, aka New Year's Eve. And my buddies, I don't know, I'm not sure where they are yet. Got all kinds of fun toys lined up, ready for playing. A lot of this stuff was kind of built back before, you know, like safety. Chad has put a fair amount of effort into figuring this thing out so completely. I'm going to have him talk about that later, because when he picked it up, we were able to get it running and stuff, but it wasn't super reliable until he did a little research and some tweaking and figuring stuff out, and he got it figured out. It's pretty fantastic. And then of course they got this beauty over here that's, you know, it's just a toy. But my goodness, look how beautiful that thing is. I'm not even sure what the heck this thing, I mean, I guess it's a tiller, but what the heck? It's got a big old Johnson on top of it. I mean, that's when you're serious about tearing some stuff up. Let's see here. Well, that tells us what the engine is. I don't necessarily know what it's for. Little output shaft there of some sort. Just engines. Sitting around. Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm gonna have to learn Japanese to be able to play with that. I don't know. What the heck is going on here? Something. Blew a tube. Not really sure. Just craziness. This thing, that starter motor, I'm pretty sure that would put out enough juice to start my Volkswagen right there. Pretty sure that coil would work too. It's crazy, man. I love it. Oh, there's another motor. A couple gas tanks. Oh, gee. Okay, so this is the ridiculousness right here. I'm gonna come around to get a better shot of that. So later on we're gonna be doing some belt sander races. This is our track, not yet set up. We'll get that done before too terribly long, but Chad decided, standard electric belt sander situation wasn't quite sufficient. And so he's been playing around with this motor he picked, I don't even remember, Harbor Freight or Amazon or something. Ooh, didn't notice that before. And so he wants a belt sander that's got just a little more oomph to it, just a little more kick. Of course, you know, it would be incomplete if we didn't also have an Evinrude and a Fisherman outboard motors. He's probably got more of them, I don't even know, somewhere. Oh, and then of course, got the, tree here, which is absolutely fantastic. Dan put that together for us. unveiled that, I don't know, a few months ago. Just ridiculous. Oh yeah, here's another. Oh yeah, here's another few. You got the Oliver here. That's a good one. All right. But you also got, you know, another Evinrude. Isn't that cute? And of course, God, look at that Johnson. That thing is pretty right there. Just silly. Just downright silly. And here's some of the lineup, the contestants as they are. I'm going to have Chad remind me on this sucker. It's all kinds of something. It's the bureau later. It keeps things cold. I don't know, it might do something more than that. It's ridiculous. I don't think it's running just yet. So we just finished setting up this track here that we'll use later for the belt sander races. But
hey, by the way, let's just look down here just for a second. Look here against the track. You may see some particles from last year's race.
That's
where it was wet. It was wet out here.
And they were slipping and sliding.
Oh, it was crazy. Yeah, it was crazy. Absolutely awesome.
So there's going to be ridiculous fun happening there later.
It will happen for sure.
But here we are, we're the day before Shemanigans 2022-23.
And I'm
helping out Chad set this up, but Chad already had a crap load of stuff out here.
We got stuff.
And I know some of it, but Chad knows all kinds of stuff about all of it. So tell me what we're looking at.
Yeah, so over here, this blue container, if you can read on the label, I'll read it for you. It is a Sears and Roebuck and Company, a Deluxe flame sprayer.
Deluxe.
Okay, so that's a Deluxe flame sprayer. Now, what's really sketchy about this is that that's a pump sprayer. You pump it up, it's got kerosene in it, and it shoots kerosene, a stream of fiery kerosene out of this thing until it gets really hot, and then it becomes like a blowtorch.
And you guys sent me a video of you guys playing with that earlier, but we will definitely get another video for this.
I was excited because I found another one, but unfortunately,
ooh,
you can check the level of your kerosene by looking into the...
Yeah, I don't think the pressure might not work as good in there, I think.
But, you know, there's always the island of misfit toys. Speaking of that, Aaron bought something that is pretty weird. This is called a hover mower. Now, you'll notice I can lift up this mower here and in because it's a plastic shroud.
Wow.
And we will have this running this weekend.
Of course we will.
And it hovers. Literally, it's a mower, and it hovers. A hover mower. So there you go.
That's going to be...
This is a 1959 Heckendorn. Not too many of these were made. Fewer. Lots of lawsuits. As you can see, you sit really high. Allow me to demonstrate.
And watch out from a camera stand, too.
What could go wrong here, right? What could go wrong? So, it's way up there, and it's a big old Briggs & Stratton engine on the back. We're hoping.
Oh, my goodness. This is where it gets real ridiculous, because it wasn't ridiculous enough.
We're hoping to do that this weekend.
You gotta do that.
We gotta do that. I think that, and it's gonna pop right in your ear all day long when you drive it, so it's really good. We don't mow.
Well, you might push the flapper on the other way so that it goes out the back.
Well, it's aerodynamic, too. This thing underneath has a unique mower design. It's actually a dish of steel with blades on the tip, kind of like a bush hog.
Yeah, okay.
So the sketchy thing about this thing is that when you start this mower, this disc starts spinning. It's got so much rotational momentum. If you hit anything, it's going to take it out.
Now, I like how you say the sketchy thing, as if there's only one.
Oh, there's more. Let me get the other one, too. I also found out that the brakes don't work when you have it neutral. So you have to have it in gear in order for brakes to work. And I was going down this road right here, which is a nice little incline. First time I got it driving,
oh, no.
I had it in neutral, and I couldn't get the brakes to work.
Yeah.
So you just turned across the hill. So there you go.
That's where you're glad, like, you can just kind of turn and go uphill, and then momentum.
It was nerve-wracking. Yes. This is a 1959-1960 Sears Craftsman Deluxe mower, $365 new back then. It would have been about $3,700 today.
And can I just say, like, right, obviously it's old and, you know, and stuff, but, like, that thing is beautiful, man. This thing is almost like it's off a Sherwin floor.
It's pretty good. There is something I'm pretty proud of, and that's the fact that I got a new old stock Tecumseh motor. The old motor was, it needs to be gone through a little bit more than I had time and energy and interest. So I put in this new Tecumseh. This legit motor is a new old stock motor from, it's produced somewhere in the 70s.
You gotta be kidding me.
And it came in a box. It was a new old stock.
Look at that.
Had never had oil in it other than at the factory.
That's ridiculous.
So, anyways.
And show me this, once you get that back in place, I want to see your thumb screw there.
Oh, yeah.
Because this is a factory screw.
Oh, yes? It is. And so, yeah, you'll notice that is a slotted screw with a washer. Brazed, probably not even welded, it's probably just brazed.
Yeah,
so that's perfect. There's some guy at some workbench somewhere making
it. I love
it. Isn't that great? Sometime we'll have this one running this weekend, and we'll you know, you can't in the background over here. This is you know, you just,
it's the big baby.
You can't not have a gathering without having something that looks something like this. She's a gem.
He's a gem. It starts so beautifully.
It's a 6-volt system. So, you know, there she goes.
God bless.
Good old tractor, 1947.
Okay.
1947 Auburn Road Cross. The claim to fame on this tractor was that it was a 6-cylinder. Different than the John Deere 2-cylinder horizontal, the old Papa Johnny thing.
Yes, okay.
It's much quieter.
And you can just take that thing down. Oh my goodness.
And I mean, it's cold. It's sitting out all night. Like, it's gotta be a choke on.
You got that thing running really nice, man.
Yeah, so that's that. And we'll probably, you know, not to throw the keys to whomever and let them drive around. I mean, it's just the way it is. It's old school, man. It's old school.
I love this thing.
And then, over here.
All right.
The one last interesting thing that's worth talking about. This is a 1930.
Oh, yes.
This is a John Deere horse and a half.
I was looking through here earlier, and I just sort of mentioned to our viewers that you like went to the extra level to figure out exactly what was going on with the ignition, I believe.
Oh,
tell us
yes.
about this.
Yeah, so this igniter, in fact, you probably want to come in here a little close. These are mica washers right in here. You see those? Those are actual cut out of mica, layers of mica rock.
Okay.
And so that's an insulator. So this is the... This is what actually delivers the spark whenever this comes back. It actually comes back. The spring opens the igniter, basically flips it back. And when it does that, this is a motor, basically an AC motor up here making current. When it does that, it breaks that briefly, causes a spark. And I had to rebuild all this. And I got a new magnet. Thank goodness I didn't have to rebuild the inside of the mag. But I didn't have to time it, which meant taking off all of this old casting. By the way, the claim to fame on this John Deere stationary engine was that it had an enclosed
the counterweight
and the
crankshaft
all that sort of stuff. Yep. it was all enclosed. So let's see if she'll start today. It's been cold out here tonight.
And she don't have any water, but it's
we'll just leave her
cool out. We're not gonna run it for too long. We've even got some video of us just working like all hell to get this thing to go, and then you spent the time to do a little book work, and now you can start it easy.
It's 1930. We're in 2022.
It's
92 years old, and it starts up like that.
It's crazy,
man. Like, that's one of the reasons why I like old tech. I mean, that's just really cool, right?
Yep. So, I love it.
Funny I'm saying these words.
The gas motor on my belt sander. Might not be the very best job ever, but it also might not be the very worst. So I'll take it. All right, so we've spliced what I hope is the supposed to be the ground. Oh yeah, I did that wrong. I'll have to redo that. Okay, that's all right. That was dumb. I should have thought that through better. So my LED light is on all the time. All right, I'm moving forward with the idea that it's possible that the green is a positive and that polarity matters, and so we're going to rewire this bad boy. Yes! All this fun stuff. Success.
This thing is so sketchy.
Yeah, you're pumping up high pressure. Like, what is it, kerosene in there?
Yeah. So this is the preheat coil, so you gotta kinda get it hot. There it goes. Turn that down.
You're just squirting kerosene.
Yeah, you gotta fill the pan with kerosene.
Oh my god. I love this thing so much already.
I know.
It's so funny how, like, this not that, that can't be that old, like 50s maybe?
Shit, I think it's from like the 70s or the 80s.
Yeah, I'm saying it's not that old, but it still seems super sketchy, huh?
And this coil has to get hot enough to vaporize the fuel.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, I knew Dan would love this because he's always making comments on safety, like, well, that's sketchy as hell.
That's so funny.
So it has to go for a while, and then eventually, when the fuel starts vaporizing, that's when it
starts doing the flamethrower business.
Yep. And you'll know it when it transitions.
I think she's starting to get close.
It's starting to get there.
You can kind of see the flame just getting a little more aggressive further up the...
So what's exactly happening here?
So there's an entire coil, like all the way to the end, is coiled up pipe. And so you're preheating the fuel to where it turns into vapor before it's launched into the...
But what is the... Is there fuel in that coil?
It is now, because that's what comes in here. It's all coiled up.
Is there like little holes to like spray the fuel?
Yep, there's there's like a 16-inch hole or a 32-inch hole.
Okay.
And it shoots out of that. I mean, I can open it up.
Oh, I see.
See?
Okay. I see.
But you want just enough to fill the pan to really get that coil hot, and once it preheats that coil, then
it's full.
There is really no shutting it down at that point. Yeah,
but right now there's no fluid actually being emitted into the front of that thing, correct?
There is. I've got fuel pissing out into the pan here.
You had it in it, right? But the valve's not open though, correct?
Yeah, the valve is open. It's cracked.
Okay, so just drizzling out in there, just to keep it getting hot. Then I see. But to turn it off, you just shut the valve and let it burn off.
Yeah, that takes about 20 minutes.
Oh my god.
Residual and everything else.
All right, here we go.
So the whole, is the end supposed to burn like that forever?
No. Come on, baby.
Oh, this is so ridiculous.
So you have the valve open just a little bit, so it's starting kind of sparking out a little bit, right? I see.
It's like
the definition.
Dad, you gotta come check this out, dude. This is so damn sketchy.
It's like the definition of sketchy.
It is like legit.
The only thing that would be better is if it was like hooked up to a compressor or some other.
That's right, catch Jennifer's car on fire. That's perfect.
What could go wrong? Park over there.
Yeah. Oh my god, I love it.
Feels good though, huh?
Yeah, right?
The marshmallows. So now you can see it's vaporizing.
Yeah, now it's going. And it's just that like tornado of flame, and I love it. So I was commenting to Chad, I have this, it's not the exact same, almost the exact same drill motor, but mine has a cap here, and take off and put drills in there. I don't know if I still have it, it might be pre-tornado, I might not still have it, but, and this may not work at all if the box won't stay still. Oh, no problem, like immediately, right through. It's not ideal, but hey, it's working, so we'll go.
One bolt in the center.
Yeah.
10 millimeter.
Jeremy wasn't, that was on the case. He was like, oh my god. I bought it. It's a bad motor.
Sander.
So we're, this is going to be an online bracket tool that we're going to use, yeah?
It is, but I don't know why. I've got some spaces here. I don't know. I'm going to have to go back and recreate it.
I'm certain that you'll have all the problems resolved. Arc a lighter station. We got Dan and our pit crew here helping out Aaron's. Do we know what the name of Aaron's contestant here, or does it even have one yet?
Yeah, it has one, but I don't know what it is.
Okay.
Okay.
It's politically correct.
Politically correct is, yeah. is the entry.
Yeah, the politically correct quarter table.
Oh yeah, PC.
You mind if I...
Genius.
Do I?
All right, I have high hopes.
We cut the shaft off. There's a clutch cup in here that is on the RC car. So this clutch cup, there's a expanding clutch on the gas powered engine. So that clutch cup then is threaded into what's left of the shaft. I was able to retain the original bearing on that. And then we roll pinned this because this is actually reverse thread, whereas this is driving correct thread. So now this belt sander goes a different direction. Like.
Dan, is it gonna run tonight?
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
All right. I like that confidence.
Yeah.
So, Dan, hey, what are we doing here, Aaron? What are we using?
We're using what you gave us.
Oh, okay.
So these are some heat sinks here. Uh-huh. You'll have to tell me what they are.
Those are off of like largely Dell PCs.
Okay. So we took these, we smashed them with a hammer, we put them into a graphite crucible, into a blacksmith. If you got one,
get real hot.
Yeah. And so then we're gonna pour it into some ingot balls and into a depression that we made with the Rad Dad logo, mm-hmm. and some casting sand. And we've got a crucible holder here, kind of a fabricated crucible holder. So this
fully custom.
So this grips the top lip and supports the bottom, keeps it from tilting. Yeah, and then we just got some horse hoof nippers to hold into this groove.
Okay.
Worked pretty well. It's a pretty good meltage here.
What would you guesstimate there? What are we looking at, like 2,000 degrees in there?
2,300 degrees, probably.
Okay. And aluminum. Aluminum melts at?
1,250 degrees.
Okay.
For pure aluminum.
Yeah.
And then aluminum oxide is 3,750. And I don't know if you can see in there or not, but...
Yeah, I think on camera it doesn't really, I can see it in person, but it doesn't really show up.
We're fully liquid, so we're fixing to go here.
Heck yeah, buddy. I'm ready.
Give us 1 second, bud.
I think I need to bring somebody neutral.
That breaks a little warm.
Well. Hey, you want to drop those little ones in there?
A little spontaneous combustion.
Here we go. go.
Build it up. Bread like molds.
Oh yeah. There we go.
Yeah, that's a proper song.
Oh god dang.
Ooh, that one's gonna be nice. That top is gonna be all flat.
We can grind our rest of it down now. All right.
Oh, that's so hot. It's so hot.
Just get them all flat while they're still a little hot.
Oh yeah, by the way, no fraternizing with the guy calling because I don't want anyone slipping a fiver to him to call theirs.
You ready?
Are we ready? You're ready. Whenever he pushes the button, all I need to know is who wins.
Oh! Standing in for Aaron's
T.O. DeWalt
against Greedy Bitch.
Greedy Bitch.
It's a Greedy Bitch right there.
We got a transfer.
Oh, full start.
Come on, let's go.
Oh. It's kind of an epic matchup right here. Golden Pecker and Red 69.
Tip my hat to
old 47. Alright, who are we racing? Old 47 or who's who?
This is flip one.
Somebody put a knot line.
Whoa! Sabotage. I don't want to sabotage.
Now, this one has been in the pits before, and the switch has been gutted. So this is what you do when the switch is gutted. You just basically tie the cord on the handle.
And we put a heat sink there too, so you can't concrete.
Oh, there you go. That's smart.
Use the heat sink for the heat sink.
Yeah, like might as well.
Picked up one by a five.
And for the big pour, the big pour.
This is the real deal.
Get it nice and close so I'm not damaging the mold here.
There you go. Or the slide. Get it. Yeah, watch the slide.
You want to watch the slide on the front?
There you go. Awesome.
There you go.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, let's make this happen, guys.
Go for it.
Go. Oh, look at that. It's so beautiful.
This other side a little bit.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Oh, okay, there you go. Pull it.
That is it.
One. Yes. Dang it.
Yes.
So for next time, we need like a little ladle. Ladle to pull the slag off.
I can forge a little spoon roll here.
Yeah, he's true.
Yeah, yeah.
Nobody
knows anywhere. It's exciting.
I mean, look at that putt. Look at the putt.
There we go.
That is so beautiful, dude. That thing is perfect. Look at that. Oh, I missed it. It was like going around and around.
I'm going to hold it right here. Just come around the top.
Dollar sign dude.
Dollar sign dude.
Against Son of Turtle. Son of Turtle in the right lane. And Dollar sign dude in the left lane.
Men of action. Ensuring that their devices are prepared. Heck yeah, dude, that's a quick fix.
That's an outstanding deal right there.
Oh, son of turtle!
Mad Max 33. Oh, dude, that looks great.
Yeah, I missed it earlier. I mispronounced greedy bitch. This is the gritty bitch.
Absolutely.
Look at it, it's so beautiful. It's shining and sparkling. That thing is, I don't know. Oh, no, get it. Oh, yeah. Is that thing? Woo! You know that's working. So we had to switch things up a little bit. We had a little bit of a fire. We lost the switch. Double A Ron at the light. Whoa! He jumped it way big time. Wow. Yeah! Son of Turtle! Yeah, the Nano or whatever. Or the Pico? Oh, yeah, yeah. Yes! Golden Pecker! Get it! Yes! Yeah! Oh my god!
You got to push the gas pedal. Come on, Golden Pecker. Your opinions on the race.
I think there was a false start in the left lane, honestly.
Oh, do you really?
I really do.
That's, I don't know. I'm gonna weigh in. No contest.
But. Okay. Still won.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Aaron, I'm just curious. There have been whispers of rumors of false start in the left lane. Is it possible?
No, there's no way.
Okay, all right. I just wanted to.
No way.
This is absurd.
This is just
more exhibition. Oh my God! The power! The power! Oh. All right, I've offered up my services as the tree operator. Oh, we got a little. We're getting ahead of the game up there. We're gonna see what happens here. Ready?
Ready.
All right. Oh my God, it's so clear. No question. This guy's a fucking animal. He just takes his hammer and slams it into the machine. Oh, you know what? Yeah.
Ready?
It's a beautiful thing here. This. Oh! Wait a second!
Oh! Yes! Yes, I love it for you, man! Yes!
Alright, ready?
Oh, come on, baby! Come on, baby! Oh! No, no, no! Get her, get her, get her, get her, get her!
I'm gonna get inside the pen.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, he got. Oh! Son of a bitch! Yeah, son of a bitch! He's torn the whole front end off of this machine. God bless. He is serious about winning. He don't care. He's got that much confidence. Up to this. Oh! Oh! All right, we got 20 minutes till midnight, just under, and we've decided we're going to make this pull start diesel motor roll for the first time. What do you think, Diego?
I think this would make a really good generator.
Okay, are we going to do it? Can we get this done?
We will.
We will. It's not just can we, it's we will.
Derelict.
Roll purple.
I've been told they're in the camp for doing stuff.
You're doing nasty?
That's what I was told.
Wait, what?
Oh. I overheard the conversation.
It's alive. It's alive. It's alive.